You are watching Travel World Online.
Hi friends. Coronavirus have created havoc around the world. The worst hit industries are travel, tourism, hospitality, and entertainment industry. There are more than 50 fake budget films which were under production at different stages have come to a standstill. The travel tourism industry, the film industry of India is facing the heat. This is high time to join hands to create synergy between the two. Today, we have got renowned film director Anil Sharma and Mr. Vivek Agnihotri. Other panelists are Mr. Sandeep Marwa, founder of Nada Film City and Marwa Studio. Mr. Rajan Sagal, co-chairman, Tourism Committee, PhD Chamber of Commerce. And Mrs. Meenakshi Sharma, DG Tourism, Government of India. Let's start with Vivek. Vivek, what is the impact of COVID-19 on Bollywood?
Hello, everyone. I think it's a great opportunity. The worst hit industries are tourism, travel, and entertainment, you know. Because they require a group all the time. So a lot of people have to come together to make it happen. So the film industry is so badly stuck that my estimate is that at least for next 1 year, in Hollywood, they've already decided that they are not going to shoot for next 1 year because health and safety regulations have to come into place. Then we don't know if the cinema halls, how they are going to operate. Will they take out two seats in between? How will it work out? You know, people stand for popcorn lines during interval. People have to go to the loo. So even if you take out two seats, people have to stand in the queue. Then will the intervals will be half an hour long? So there are a whole lot of unanswered questions which nobody knows anything about.
Chuji, thank you very much.
Hi, Anil. How are you?
Hi, how are you? Kya hal
hai? Hi, Anil.
So, currently the biggest problem is, see, I am one of the victims. No, I mean, it's a wrong word to use, not very sensitive word. I mean, yes, we also suffered because of this, because I was leaving on the 16th to shoot my next film, The Kashmir Files, with the entire unit. We have already paid to hotels and we have booked all the, you know, 100 plus people. We have booked air tickets. We have paid to all the locations, to the people. So whole investments have gone into it. And on the 15th evening, we checked with the Home Ministry where we were going to shoot. And they said, please don't come because we are ready with Section 144. So we realized the gravity of the matter. Immediately, I canceled on 15th night. So, but then everybody is employed. And if you understand the structure of film shooting, you get 200-300 people together, you know, for almost 9 months to 1 year. And you just pay them for all those 8-9 months and they're committed to do the film, you're committed to make the payments. So that's the problem. And the third problem is, so one, I told you how it's going to play out in the future, we don't know. It's definitely not looking great. The second thing, all the films which were going to shoot, they are stuck now. How long can they sustain to keep paying? And the third biggest problem is, that the summer was coming and both in Bollywood and Hollywood or Tollywood, whatever you want to call, but every single film industry for summer has the biggest films to offer. So a whole lot of these Superman movies and VFX big budget $1 billion movies in India, if you see Suryavanshi, then 83, these are huge big films costing a couple of hundred rupees each. All of them are stuck to release. They were releasing 1 month ago. Now there is no future when they're going to release. So as a consequence, yes, a lot of people say that OTT platform will start taking films and people will start watching. But that's a myth. It's a very big myth. Because on OTT, people just watch very big films and not unknown films. And OTT, can they sustain this kind of budgeting is also can't be answered at this stage. So this is the biggest problem with Bollywood.
Mr. Marwa, how do you see the impact of coronavirus on Indian film industry?
I'll start with the figures. It's very important first to know that media and entertainment industry is the sixth biggest industry in the country. 6 million people are directly connected to this industry. The one industry which was growing at the rate of 12% per annum and was so far been one of the best contributors to the total GDP of the country, because the average GDP before this whole affair was only 4.5 to 5% GDP. And media and entertainment industry has been growing at the rate of 12%, and we've always been a contributor to the whole growth of the country, because average jo hai wo ye industry badi achhi bana rahi thi. The next point, very important to know that 10,000 theaters in this country, imagine, and 1.5 crore people watch cinema every day. Now, why I'm telling you these figures? Because that will give the overall picture that what a big setback to the whole industry as a whole. We are handicapped, we are stuck, and the total loss is going to be massive, which probably may take more than 2 to 3 years to recover for time to come.
Rajan, you're organizing film conclaves in Ceylon. This is crucial time for Bollywood and travel and tourism industry. Both are losing. How do you see the synergy between the two? Can this bring some change?
Because, you know, tourism are the main, films are the main tool to promote a country or a destination. You know, our theme for this conclave was how to convert locations into vocations. Because, you know, once the film is shot at a particular destination, it was giving a big boost to tourism to develop that destination. People want to see where their celebrities have done the shooting. They come to know about a place which they have not seen in any book or in a documentary. So, you know, it's a main source of business, and I think our DG man will also agree with me that films are doing a lot to promote country or a destination for the tourism purpose. You know, films like Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara, which was shot in Spain, the traffic from India to Spain within 6 months have gone up by 21%. And when Three Idiots were shot in Ladakh, the traffic, the flights were fully chock-a-block to Ladakh, you know. So you can imagine, if the film is shot and we do the marketing of that destination with the film, I think it is the best way to promote a destination. And post-COVID, post this crisis, I think film will play a major role, because lots of foreign films which were half complete in Europe or other countries, now we should offer them India as a best location, give them best facilities we can offer them. So India will bring on the film map, and we can promote it as a destination.
Meenakshi ma'am, what is your views on this?
So thank you very much for inviting me here. We all understand the impact of films on everybody's life. We also all understand that how much of a setback, and what Mr. Agnihotri and Mr. Marwa talked about, that it is going to be very, very different. The present losses, the future, what are we looking at, and how the future would really work out is not really known to any of us. One thing is for very sure, that the losses are going to be there. Things are going to be difficult. There is no escaping that fact. There, as everybody has been talking about, there are two things now. One is pre-COVID-19 and a post-COVID-19. The realities are going to be very different. But that being said, let's look it this way. We are already in this situation. How do we really look at survival, revival, and growth? That is the term which we are using. If one sector which has been much worse affected is travel, because even if the films will come much faster, travel will not come out that much faster. The tourism is going to take even a worse hit than the films, because films are so much part of our life. It is maybe a different way of looking at it. So so that's a good and a bad news. However, now, because I'm talking to the whole travel and tourism community every day, I think in a twice a day, and we know what a big problem is. There are certain questions which are across the board. There are questions like the liquidity is going to be an issue with all of us, whichever industry we are talking of. Some are very badly affected, like aviation and tourism and the film maybe. Some are little less. The another thing is about how do we keep the industries going. That is another thing. And then there's the practical aspect of what we can do to bring a revival. So I think if I talk about that, the one thing is that we are looking for your suggestions now. Survival, we have already got a lot of suggestions from, and I don't see really coming out with the more suggestion than which are already there. There is a huge, and I think Ministry of Finance, Ministry of INB, Ministry of Tourism, Ministry of Commerce, DIPP, every one of us are talking in detail on each and every aspect. Survival, whether we are talking of unorganized workforce or we are talking of industry per se, is already being thought about. How much of it can be given by government is a different issue, because there are going to be priorities, there are going to be timeline what can be given. But what is more interesting for us would be, what do each industry is looking for revival and growth? So the basically the midterm, which is the next 6 months, and then the long term. So as far as Ministry of Tourism is concerned, I can talk about more about the film tourism. I can't talk about the film industry, and I'm sure the concerned ministry, that is INB, is already, I'm sure you are in talking to them. As far as the film tourism is concerned, so can I can just finish my this last statement. So the fact remains is that there is going to be a rigidity in the borders. The international borders are not going to open so fast, because unless so let's keep that fact in mind, and that applies both ways. It is applies about shooting in India, shooting abroad, or foreign movies getting shot in India. So let's keep that in mind for some time to come, till vaccine is there, till the vaccine becomes successful and the things try to come to the earlier normal, because there is going to be a new normal, as all of us know. So there is going to be a rigidity in international borders. Keeping in that in mind, please let us know your specific suggestion for what we can do. We are very much interested in talking to the state government, looking at certain policy intervention. How can we make the film tourism more affordable? How can we help you in bringing up, you know, destination? Because if you go to shoot there, it becomes a destination. Mr. Sehgal has just spoken about it, and we can make it. There are so many new destinations which are coming, which can be explored. Actually, just before that, we were coming out with a compilation of places which can be really good for film tourism. We can take those initiatives and go ahead. Thank you very much for giving me so much time. Yeah, Mr. Marwa was saying something.
No, I was just saying, I said things are looking so different right now. People are hesitant. People are not comfortable in coming out of the house. Forget about making of a cinema. And then by hook or crook, if you're going to make cinema, who's going to see it? I was just going through a figure that we have 31 crore students sitting in 15 lakh schools and 700 universities in this country, and 40,000 colleges. And they are the real customer in India for seeing films, and in 10,000 theaters. Theaters are jahan jahan rush hai. Wherever there is going to be a crowd, is going to be a problem for the next 1 year. That's the, no, because the ultimate for us, cinema house is a temple. That's a real house of earning money. And if people are not going to enter into it, it's going to have a reverse effect. The first thing which I am seeing is that number of films will drop down. Second, very important, which is coming, that films are going to be now less in number and small in their units. People will take very small units. Subjects will change. Thinking will change. People can't go for a bigger, higher projects.
Sorry to interrupt you, Mr. Marwa. You know, the main motive of this is, you know, what are the challenges now? People are not able to shoot for another 1 year outside India. You know, what are the challenges? Anil Sharma ji, would you like to put some light on this?
जी बिल्कुल जी जी बिल्कुल मैं अभी सबको सुन रहा था एंड आई एम रियली कंसर्न जो सब लोग बोल रहे हैं ऑलमोस्ट एवरीबॉडी इज टॉकिंग वेरी सेंस एंड बिकॉज दिस ये जो न्यू प्रॉब्लम आई है न्यू परिस्थिति आई है पूरे देश में और पूरे देश में क्या पूरे संसार में ये कभी हुआ ही नहीं मैं तो पढ़ता रहता हूँ आजकल समय समय देखता रहता हूँ तो पिछले 1000 साल में भी ऐसा कभी नहीं हुआ कि जहाँ 200 कंट्री प्रभावित हुए हों तो डेफिनेटली एक प्रॉब्लम तो है इट इज अ बिगर प्रॉब्लम देन फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वन फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड टू और या पार्टीशन से भी बड़ी प्रॉब्लम हुई है, बिकॉज कभी हुई नहीं 200 कंट्री जब प्रभावित हुए हो, तो डेफिनेटली इट्स अ प्रॉब्लम इट्स अ कंसर्न, सबके लिए कंसर्न है, एंड इट इज गोइंग टू टेक टाइम एंड वी हैव टू लिव विद इट, वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड विद इट, 6 महीने हो, साल भर हो, इम्पोर्टेंट ये है कि ये प्रॉब्लम की वैक्सीन आए, हम लोग इस प्रॉब्लम से निकले. थिंग्स विल चेंज, टाइम विल चेंज, टाइम हर चीज बदलती है, ये अच्छा समय नहीं रहता तो बुरा समय भी नहीं रहता, ये भी बदलेगा, इट मे टेक सम टाइम, ओनली वन थिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वी हैव टू कीप आवर पेशेंस एंड दैट इज ओनली द की.
Vivek ji and Anil ji, in my views, there's no place like India on this planet Earth. We have got all kind of locations to meet Bollywood industry's needs, from period films to romantic films, suspense thrillers to horror films. So why India is not the first choice for Indian Bollywood industry? What is missing? Where?
I agree with you. I would like to tell you.
Can I answer that? Because I got to leave, you know. So I'll just finish it and then I can leave. Arey, Anil ji, aap bolo. Sorry, main suna nahi.
Nahi, aap bolo, aap bolo, aap bolo.
So, acha, listen. Yes, India has a lot of beautiful cities and people shoot in all Indian cities. And I don't think there is any filmmaker who doesn't know about Indian cities. Anil ji, हम सब जमीन से जुड़े हुए लोग हैं, सो दैट्स नॉट द इशू. एंड राइट नाउ नोबडी इज गोना से हे दैट सिटी इज ब्यूटीफुल एंड लेट्स गो एंड शूट, दैट इज इंपॉसिबल, दैट्स नॉट गोना हैपन. कि लोग कहेंगे अरे वाह वो शहर अच्छा है चलो शूट, तो दैट अजम्पशन इज ऑफ नो यूज. ओके, बट द बिगेस्ट, मीनाक्षी जी, यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सजेशंस, सो आई जस्ट वेरी हम्बली आई जस्ट सबमिट वन सजेशन टू यू.
I think this is perfect time to promote Indian locations. I'm sure there are lots and lots of films which have been shot abroad, and but that shouldn't be a problem because it can be easily tackled. You just need few plates from the location where you shot, and you can shoot it against green, what is called chroma in filmmaking. But the whole problem about promoting Indian locations is that it's not about the location only. It's also the kind of hotels you have, airport facility, travel facility, safety. So there are a whole lot of issues involved with this, you know. So logistics, police protection, the crowd. So if all these things can be tied up, the problem with Indian locations is that, yes, locations are beautiful, but the logistics are sometimes very bad. So I hope the government will look in this direction. We have to work on logistics. And yes, then we are in place. And the films which have already been shot, they can be managed by shooting them on chroma. So I am looking for good times. It may take a week or so, but ultimately we are looking at better times as far as Indian travel is concerned, because people will not be willing to go abroad for shooting for long time.
Now, at this stage, more than 50 films are stuck. Big budget films outside India.
I just shared this. About 150 films are ready to be certified by the CBFC. So, which means more than 150 and films are stuck.
No, the films which were people who were shooting outside India. So, approximately 50 big budget films are outside. Do you see any chance to complete those films in India or in the future? Can we do something? Because, you know, if Bollywood and tourism industry goes hand in hand, we can go a long way.
Yes, it's a technical thing. Anil Sharma ji knows it very well. I think the dependence on a green screen of shooting on chroma. So it's very easy. You can send just one cameraman and one person anywhere, and they can just go and get the plates, you know, because, and
the
also
story, the stories for foreign location, they have to be changed, and man to man contact will reduce even in cinema. The new concept, science fiction, like animation, these
VFX,
kind of things bigger now. They will emerge much bigger.
VFX is going to be special effects, and VFX animation is going to be a huge industry. That's where government should be looking at how they can help the animation industry.
From fiction films to there'll be diversion, and people will start thinking of different concepts so that they need less people and less body-to-body contact, less crowd. And the second point which madam asked, that was very valid, that it is for sure.
Sorry, Marwa sahab, I have to rush. I told them I will have to leave. So, aap sabka thank you very much.
Aap hamesha nikal jaate hain.
No. I have to. I have no option. I was supposed to be some teacher downstairs. I'm doing a lot of community service, so I have to be down at 5:30 sharp. So I'm sorry, okay. I have to go. No. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Namaskar. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Marwa, let's ask Anilji. So, what's his take on this shooting in India? How we can start doing that Bollywood and tourism destinations? Because
देखो इंडिया तो बहुत ही ब्यूटीफुल है. मैंने तो बहुत फिल्में इंडिया में शूट की है और डेफिनेटली ये बहुत बड़ी अपॉर्चुनिटी है क्योंकि ये निश्चित है कि बहुत एक डेढ़ दो साल तक बाहर शूटिंग करने की परमिशन भी नहीं मिलेगी आपको. ये बहुत सही बात की मारवा साहब ने कि वो बहुत सारे सब्जेक्ट जिसमें फॉरेन लोकेशन है उनको थोड़ा सा एलिमिनेट करना चाहिए और वो सारे सब्जेक्ट जो कि भारत में शूट हो सकते हैं वैसी कहानियां बनानी चाहिए. और भारत में लोकेशंस की कमी नहीं है और इसमें टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट की जिम्मेदारी है कि ये प्रोड्यूसर्स तक कैसे भी उन सब लोकेशंस को पहुंचाए. क्योंकि क्या हो रहा है कि हम लोगों को तो कुछ लोकेशंस मालूम है, जो लोकेशंस हमको मालूम है जो हमारे लाइन प्रोड्यूसर्स हमें बताते हैं या जो हमने दिए हैं, कुछ मनाली हो गया, कुछ श्रीनगर हो गया, कुछ उत्तराखंड हो गया, कुछ जो बेसिक जो लोकेशंस है, कुछ जयपुर हो गया, कुछ कलकत्ता हो गया, कुछ थोड़ी बहुत लोकेशन कुछ ईस्ट कुछ उत्तर प्रदेश की कुछ लोकेशंस हो गई. लेकिन भारत में तो बहुत सारी लोकेशंस हैं. उन लोकेशंस तक पहुंचा कैसे जाए, उन लोकेशन तक पहुंचने की व्यवस्था कैसे हो और वो लोकेशंस के फोटोग्राफ्स चीजें ये सब चीजें और उनके नाम अगर ये टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट थोड़ा अपनी तरफ से मेहनत करे तो डेफिनेटली ये एक इतनी बड़ी अपॉर्चुनिटी है अभी आने वाले समय में कि ये आप थोड़ा सा इकट्ठा करें और फिल्म प्रोड्यूसर तक पहुंचाएं तो डेफिनेटली ये प्रोड्यूसर्स के लिए बहुत ही अच्छी बात होगी. डायरेक्टर्स वुड लाइक टू शूट इट और इट विल बी मोर कन्वीनियंट ऑल्सो. सो दिस इज अ बिग अपॉर्चुनिटी. द टूरिज्म ऑफ इंडिया मस्ट लुक टुवर्ड्स दिस साइड एंड गेट रेडी फॉर दिस. दिस इज 100% ट्रू. वी मस्ट शूट इन इंडिया एंड वी कैन ब्यूटिफुल शूट इन इंडिया.
इसी में सजेशन है कि 28 ऑल द स्टेट्स एंड 9 यूनियन टेरिटरीज ऑफ इंडिया all of them have their tourism board or a tourism department, and it's a high time and a right time to put a word, as ma'am said, put a word to all these people. They should immediately expedite, become more alert, conscious and more service oriented and be ready to serve Indian film industry. We make around 2600 films in a year. It's a huge thing. Largest in the world. तो अगर हिंदुस्तान में तो हिंदुस्तान का पैसा भी हिंदुस्तान में रहेगा, हिंदुस्तान का टूरिज्म भी बढ़ेगा और सारे स्टेट्स खिलकर फिल्मों से सारे देश को पता चलेंगे. और जो अभी 100 करोड़ का टूरिज्म है हमारा इंटरनल टूरिज्म, यू नो दैट 100 करोड़ पीपल दे विजिट एवरी ईयर, इट बिकम मच बिगर देन दैट टाइम टू कम.
अनिल जी, व्हाइल शूटिंग इन इंडिया, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स यू फेस इन जनरली?
कोई हिकअप नहीं है. मैंने तो बहुत शूटिंग की, कोई भी हिकअप नहीं है हिंदुस्तान में. बात क्या होती है कि जिस डायरेक्टर को भाई अगर मैंने सब्जेक्ट की विदेश का लिया है तो मुझे विदेशी शूट करना पड़ेगा. थोड़ा सा है जैसे यहाँ पे आप उत्तराखंड में ऊपर की तरफ औली की तरफ आप चले जाए तो व्यवस्था ही नहीं है, पहुंचे कैसे आदमी, शूटिंग करे कैसे. ऐसे ही बहुत सारी चीजें, हिमाचल में बहुत सारी ऐसी जगह है जो कमाल कमाल की लोकेशन से उतना दूर पहुंचे कैसे, जाए कैसे. आप अगर स्विट्जरलैंड जाते हैं, आप अगर ऑस्ट्रेलिया जाते हैं, आप अगर यूएसए जाते हैं, इंग्लैंड जाते हैं, जो बेस्ट से बेस्ट लोकेशंस हैं वहां पहुंचने के इतने बढ़िया तरीके हैं और इतने अच्छे साधन हैं. बर्फ कितनी भी हो, -20 डिग्री टेम्परेचर में, अब मैंने जम्फरों में शूट किया था लेकिन मैं इतना कंफर्टेबल था क्योंकि व्यवस्थाएं इतनी अच्छी थी मेरे लिए, नहीं टूरिस्ट के लिए, कि मुझे वहां सर्दी ही नहीं लगती थी. हर चीज इतनी करेक्टली पेश हुआ करती थी सबके सामने आपके. तो जो व्यवस्थाएं हैं सरकार की तरफ से उन उन प्रदेशों में जो बहुत ही ब्यूटीफुल लोकेशंस है. आज जैसे मैं औली की बात की मैंने आपको अभी उत्तराखंड के अंदर, औली इतनी कमाल की लोकेशंस है, लोकेशन है, लेकिन मुझे नहीं लगता औली में आज तक कभी किसी ने शूटिंग की उससे ज्यादा. हजारों शूटिंगें हुई स्विट्जरलैंड में, वाई नॉट इन औली. आज से जब मैं महाराजा की शूटिंग कर रहा था 96 में, तब मैंने गवर्नमेंट को बोला था कि ओली को आप डेवलप करो, इतनी ब्यूटीफुल लोकेशन है, वहां तक पहुंचने की कोई व्यवस्था नहीं है, मुझे पहुंचने में 8-9 घंटे लगते हैं लेकिन आज तक ओली वहीं की वहीं है. इतनी सुंदर लोकेशन है. ऐसे ही हिमाचल के अंदर भी अंदर हम लोग जाते हैं तो मैं 8-9 घंटे का ट्रेवल करके बाई रोड गया हूँ. जब फिल्में बहुत सारी थी गदर के टाइम पे, मैं हिमाचल में इतना इंटीरियर गया शूट करने के लिए लेकिन वहां पहुंचने की व्यवस्था ही नहीं है। तो मान लो मैं थोड़ा पागल हूं, मैं थोड़ा अंदर तक चला जाऊंगा शूट करने के लिए, लेकिन हर कोई नहीं जाएगा। सो जो सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम है, यू डोंट हैव द ट्रेवलिंग की, ट्रेवल की कोई सुविधा नहीं है आपके पास वहां पहुंचने की। ना वहां कोई एयरपोर्ट है, ना वहां कोई, आप चौपर से जा सकते हैं, ना वहां कोई ट्रेन से जा सकते हैं, ना वहां कोई बसों से जा सकते हैं, इतनी छोटी छोटी रोड है। तो ये व्यवस्था कैसे बनेगी, ये और ना वहां कोई इस तरह के होटल्स है कि वहां आप रह सके। तो ये सब व्यवस्थाएं बनानी पड़ेंगी। ये सब व्यवस्थाओं के लिए गवर्नमेंट ऑफ टूरिज्म को ही कुछ करना पड़ेगा, टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट को ही, भारत के हर प्रांत के टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट को उसके लिए वर्क करना पड़ेगा। आप चाहते हैं कि यहाँ पे जो जैसे आदमी को जो कंफर्ट जोन मिलता है विदेश में शूटिंग करने का, अगर आप इसीलिए आदमी विदेश जाता है शूटिंग करने के लिए, अगर आप चाहते हैं कि हिंदुस्तान में हर व्यक्ति, यहाँ का हर डायरेक्टर वहां शूट करे, तो वो फैसिलिटेट आपको करना पड़ेगा, फैसिलिटीज देनी पड़ेंगी। लेकिन वो फैसिलिटीज तो देनी पड़ेंगी ना, उसके लिए तो काम करना पड़ेगा। लेकिन आई एम सॉरी टू से, उस तरह का कोई काम होता नहीं है।
मैंने तो बेसिक मॉडलिटीज तैयार नहीं है ना।
आप देखिए ना, श्रीनगर, श्रीनगर में मैं एक किस्सा सुनाना चाहता हूँ आप लोगों को। आप एक सेकंड का एक किस्सा सुनाना चाहता हूँ, आप सुनिए। एक दफे आज से मैं शूटिंग कर रहा था, शायद तहलका या फरिश्ते की 15-20 साल पुरानी, 25 साल पुरानी बात है। मुझे किसी ने बताया, मुझे किसी चरवाहे ने मुझे बताया कि एक फलानी जगह बहुत अच्छी लोकेशन है। मैं श्रीनगर से चला, श्रीनगर से मेरे को 2 घंटा ड्राइव करके वहां जाना पड़ा। 2 घंटा ड्राइव किया, फिर वहां से मैंने जीप बदली, जीप बदल के मैं 1 घंटा जीप में गया ऊपर पहाड़ों पे। वहां से मैं पोनी पे बैठा, और पोनी पे बैठ के पहाड़ों के ऊपर से मैं 1.5 घंटा ट्रेवल करके, पोनी से 1.5 घंटा ट्रेवल करके मैं एक वैली में पहुंचा। मैंने अपने जीवन में इतनी सुंदर वैली कभी देखी नहीं, लेकिन मैं वहां शूट नहीं कर सका। मेरे पास कोई रास्ता नहीं था वहां शूट करने का। मैंने उसी क्षण सोचा था कि मैंने कहा ये जगह अगर लंदन अमेरिका कहीं होती तो ये जगह इस वक्त संसार का स्वर्ग होती थी। मेरे जीवन में आज भी उस जगह की, उस वैली की स्मृति आज भी है। जैसे हम जब विजुअल इफेक्ट में कोई हम दुनिया बनाते हैं, कोई संसार बनाते हैं, तो वो कितना सुंदर लगता है विजुअल इफेक्ट के थ्रू, इतना सुंदर था। तो भारत में सुंदरता की कमी नहीं है, बात क्या है, उन लोगों की कमी है जो कि उस सुंदरता को सिनेमा तक पहुंचा सके, चाहे वो फिल्म डायरेक्टर हो, चाहे वो टूरिज्म डिपार्टमेंट हो, चाहे भारत की।
थैंक यू अनिल जी, योर क्लोजिंग रिमार्क।
ओके जी, ओके, थैंक यू वेरी मच, थैंक
यू।
बस मैं यही कहना चाहूंगा, नॉर्थ ईस्ट भी बहुत कमाल की जगह है, वहां भी व्यवस्था कराएं। नॉर्थ ईस्ट संसार की सबसे सुंदर जगह है, प्लीज डू समथिंग। दिस इज द बेस्ट टाइम फॉर इंडियन टूरिज्म और हिंदुस्तानी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री के लिए, दोनों के लिए बहुत अच्छा समय है। भारत की फिल्में भारत में शूट हों, भारत के लोग देखें, संसार के लोग देखें, इससे बढ़िया बात कोई नहीं हो सकती। लेट्स वर्क टुगेदर ऑन दिस। मैं बस यही कह रहा था कि हिंदुस्तान में लोकेशंस की कमी नहीं है, लेकिन वहां तक पहुंचने की और वहां सुविधाओं की थोड़ी सी कमी है। तो ये सही समय है, सही मौका है कि पूरे भारत की टूरिज्म मिनिस्ट्री और सारे प्रांत मिलकर, एक आपस में मिलकर कोऑर्डिनेट करें और योजना बनाएं, और उस योजना के तहत अच्छी अच्छी लोकेशंस मार्क करें, और वहां तक पहुंचने के रास्ते, वहां तक की सुविधाओं के रास्ते मार्क करें, ताकि और वो फिल्म इंडस्ट्री तक पहुंचे, ताकि वहां पर हम लोग शूटिंगें कर सकें। और भारत में लोकेशंस की बिल्कुल कमी नहीं है, भारत बहुत ही सुंदर देश है, और चाहे वो नॉर्थ ईस्ट हो, या हिमाचल हो, या श्रीनगर हो, या उत्तराखंड हो, या कोई भी प्रांत, कोई भी प्रदेश हो, इवन उड़ीसा हो, साउथ हो, कोई भी जगह हो, तो वो सब जगह के लिए हम लोग शूटिंग कर सकें। उनकी हमें सुख साधन और साधनों का प्रोड्यूसर्स और डायरेक्टर्स के लिए और फिल्म मेकिंग के लिए आप लोग व्यवस्था करें, इससे बढ़िया बात कोई नहीं हो सकती। थोड़ी मेहनत का काम है, थोड़ी सी मेहनत हम सब लोग मिलकर करेंगे तो जरूर कर लेंगे, बस यही कहना है मुझे।
मिस्टर महावर, यू वुड लाइक टू ऐड समथिंग?
Well, I think the new opportunity is coming today, where now film producers and directors will go out of way to explore India, and they will look for better locations in India and alternate locations in India, which is going to bring tourism and to Indian states, and the revenue is going to stay back in India. And it may take little time, but now they are forced to do this. Because I don't think so, so easily international borders will be opened for shooting purposes. Because to start, it will start the medical reasons, then it will start with the official works, and probably cinema will come little later. But, and people who are desperate to finish their cinema, desperate to finish their films which are almost half done, they need place. And the second alternate which is going to come is that indoor sets will come back now. Indoor sets will come back. Jo bhool gaye the log studio ke andar shooting karna, wo wapas shuru ho jayega. And very humbly, I can, through you, pass on this message to the whole Indian film industry. Once again, though I am also chairing International Chamber of Media and Entertainment Industry, which has emerged now as one of the most important chamber in the country and abroad, and we have almost 145 countries member here. The most important thing is, sir, ke I am ready from Noida Film City, from Marwa Studios, to provide infrastructure for all those producers and directors who are keen in shooting in North India, any of these 14, 15 states. I'm ready to give them infrastructure at a most subsidized rates. Main unko अपनी तरफ से ये फैसिलिटी देना चाहता हूँ क्योंकि उसके बाद सरकारी फैसिलिटी जुड़ेगी.
एंड अनिल शर्मा जी राइटली सेड एंड द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टूरिज्म अलोन कांट डू एवरीथिंग यू नो दे कैन गिव अस अ लीड और दे कैन गिव अस सम काइंड ऑफ यू नो मोटिवेशन बट आई थिंक इट्स थ्रू अवर चैम्बर थ्रू अवर टूरिज्म कमेटी वी विल फाइंड द लोकेशंस इन इंडिया विच आर नॉट टू क्राउडेड विच आर अनएक्सप्लोर्ड लाइक ग्वालियर ओरछा खजुराहो in places in Uttarakhand, in Northeast, beaches and temples of Odisha, you know, we can go there and we tell the Bollywood or some foreign films also that these are beautiful locations and we can talk to states also. I think our chamber will do, the tourism committee will do a homework and give this paper to Ministry of Tourism.
Okay. Meenakshi ma'am, are you there? Please respond to him.
Yeah. So, you know, whatever, I think a lot of valid points have been made. And I think there is a need for creating the right connectivity and also exposing. But I can say now the things which are being talked about, connectivity is much better. Now we have a lot of airports and chopper services to very beautiful locations. So it's not that things have not improved. But things need to be improved in a fast manner now, because this is the, as we know, is an opportunity. Lot of films can be shot in various parts. And I will just mention when I started that we actually started working with the one or two organization to create a directory of the such location and the connectivity. I think now with the help of all the state government, we will take it up very fast, so that there are two things now. The one is, what are these locations which might be liked by the film directors? What are the problems of connectivity and reaching there, or whether the infrastructure is there for providing the basic facilities? And the third thing, are policy friendly for the film shooting? These are the three things which I think are the challenges. And in some states, it is better, in some states not. Like, for example, I realize there are still a lot of shooting gets done in Madhya Pradesh now. Last they have tried to come out with a policy which is very positive. We can work with them. So I would be very happy to receive some very concrete suggestion after today's this thing. And I can assure you that we will try to do whatever needs to be done at the Government of India level, whether it is my ministry or information broadcasting, or it's the state government. I'm sure we can handle all these issues. Connectivity, and I take his point, even I have seen beautiful places, and I always think, why do we ever go to Switzerland? There are such beautiful places in Himachal, Uttarakhand, even Northeast. Now with a lot of difficulties, we have started opening Northeast for things. And we can work for film tourism for Northeast also. There are some places which are just out of the world. So I think all the three things, one is the connectivity, a directory where it can be done, and the positive policy. We should work on that, because as we said, it's an opportunity. Things are changing, let's change
with it. और उसमें हमारे किसी सहयोग की आवश्यकता हो तो जरूर बोलिएगा
जरूर। थैंक यू।
फिल्म में शूट हो
और यहाँ की लोकेशन है पूरा संसार देखे, अगर ऐसा होगा तो मैं सबसे ज्यादा खुश फील करूंगा अपने आप को। धन्यवाद मुझे बुलाने के लिए, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
थैंक्स अ लॉट एवरीवन, थैंक यू वेरी मच मैडम।
यू आर वॉचिंग ट्रैवल वर्ल्ड ऑनलाइन।